It's Absolute Radio, and tonight in session, I'm delighted to welcome Edwyn Collins. Hello.
Hi.
Or to address you by your proper title, you are chieftain of the Highland Games of
in
of where?
Helmsdale. So actually,
what does that entail?
It entails chieftain of the Highland Games, Edwyn, and I'm honoured generally, and it's a good idea. It's I'm honoured. That's outrageous, in fact.
What do you have to do?
Up in Helmsdale, mingle with people,
yep.
Talk to each other, and chat to each other, and that's it.
Had you previously been to any Highland Games?
No. And my granddad was born in the house.
Yeah.
And it's my house now, and it's Grace's house now, and it's up in Helmsdale, relaxing, and
yeah.
It's great to.
You can talk about how you had your full regalia and your kilt and stuff.
Okay. Grace is in the corner. Edwin's missus. You got to wear the full Highland outfit then.
Yes, I did, and the kilt and the sporran.
Yeah,
and all that and. I'm not sure about that, the sporran idea, but...
it's not something you're going to be wearing in everyday life.
Yes, correct.
And were you... You mean, I always think of you as having lived in the city for a long time.
Yes, I have.
So that experience of getting out, because you're spending a lot of time at Helmsdale.
Yes.
Has that changed you?
Yes, it also alters me, but Grace loves it. Doesn't she? I love it too, but I prefer the studio, actually. But
yep.
Grace doesn't. She prefers Helmsdale.
But it's unsurprising that.
Yeah, yes.
Speaking of the studio, the record Losing Sleep, am I right in thinking that the last thing you did, it was something you'd finished, you were finishing off something you were working on before
yes.
the illness, and so this is the first record you've made since
yes,
the illness?
Yes, correct.
And was there any part of you that was worried? Because, I mean, we don't know about brains. Was there any part of you that worried that bit of your brain wouldn't work how it used to?
Yes. I'm still getting better. 6 months in hospital,
yeah.
I couldn't say a thing. But Grace Maxwell and the possibilities are endless, over and over and over again.
Have you got any idea where that came from, the possibilities are endless?
No.
Because it's so beautiful that was the thing.
Yeah, really?
Yeah. It just came and you don't know where from.
But... possibly I was backward. I'm still backward.
Right.
But my singing is not backward at all.
Yeah.
But my talking is getting better, let's say.
Yeah.
But it's still dodgy, let's say.
But the singing is fine.
Yes.
Well, that's your bread and butter.
Yes.
You've got to, on the record, there's lots of guests. I just want to talk through some of the people you worked with and find out what your connection with them. Franz Ferdinand, who, when I first heard them, I thought they
were... Do It Again, it's called.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I thought they, you know, when I first heard them, straight away I thought Orange Juice.
Really?
Yeah, did you make that connection the first time you heard Franz Ferdinand?
No. I must admit, Do It Again... It's like Franz Ferdinand, I suppose, and a bit like Orange Juice to an extent, but it's like Franz Ferdinand. But Alex doesn't think so. He's it likes Orange Juice, but still, I'm flattered in a way.
How did you get to know him?
I met him in Bixon Academy. I met him recently. The Glasgow School is called the Orange Juice. orange juice and the CD.
Yeah.
And it's coming out in Domino Records, actually. But I met him, Alex, and he's great to work with in the studio.
Yeah.
And he's fast, and I'm fast also.
No mucking about.
Yes, yeah. No mucking about.
And then also on the record is somebody who's been on this programme many times, yeah. Ruddy Frame, yes. You've known since he was just a young boy.
When I was 16, Ruddy's.
Yeah.
And I was 20, actually. Yeah.
What was your first memory of him? Do you because he's obviously a very prodigious talent.
Yeah, yeah. Ruddy's my friend and... at first, 16 he was, and I was 20. He's quite shy, and I remember Glasgow times, Byard's Road, walking on Roddy and I together, chatting away and conversing away.
Yeah.
And it's he's come on out as woodwork. No.
Yeah.
Special.
It's only taken this many years.
Yeah. Yes.
And you've got James playing guitar with you tonight. Yeah, hello, yes. James.
Hello.
Where did you find James?
Oh, he's working with the Pretenders. He's working as solo and Calman's working also.
Yeah, yeah.
Yep. So tell him about that, Dave.
Like playing the Pretenders, and we've got a solo album coming out on Heavenly next January, I believe. I've known Edwyn for a while now.
Yeah, yeah.
Met you in Dublin.
Yeah, yeah, and walking in home again, actually.
Yeah, oh yeah, that's right.
Yeah, slide guitar.
Mandolin, was it?
Yeah, yeah, and what's that song called again? Last one. I cried.
That's right.
Yeah, I cried.
Your son is just going into the music business.
Yes, he's 20 years old and he's learning to play the guitar. He was learning 2 years, 3 years, and he's good at the guitar, especially acoustic guitar and bass too, and he's quite good at it.
So you didn't give him a fatherly chat and try and discourage him from the music industry?
No, not at all. But... what it is, William said, you think you are in the family business, you have another thing coming, but gradually the guitar, he likes it. He's practicing away and he's I must admit, he's good at it.
Yeah. And is he touring with the Cribs working on the merchandise stall?
No, Frankie and the Heartstrings.
Right.
And me, Edwyn Collins, the King Beats.
Yeah.
They come from Germany, but Kilburn.
Is that right?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, it's a smart move. I mean, the merchandise stall is where the money is these days,
yeah.
Isn't it?
And he's good at it.
Yeah.
Trust me on that subject.
And when you first went into music, were your family encouraging of you?
No. Not at all. No. He's Grandpa Stuart, he's not encouraging me at all.
Yeah.
My mum.
Yep.
She's proud of me, actually.
Yeah, yeah.
But back then in Orange's times, I was a bit of a punk, and let's say a bit of a nuisance, actually. My mother spared of me, actually.
What do you think she would rather have you done back then?
Maybe become a lawyer,
yeah.
Possibly, but I'm not for that. I like pop music and rock music and indie music, I guess.
Yep. So you're going out on tour.
Yes.
People can see you up and down the country.
Yes, November. The 6th, I think. Fourth.
Remember the 4th of November
in this instance.
Yes. And do you use Twitter and MySpace and all those things?
Yes, I do. But Greece is generally use Twitter, and I prefer Facebook, actually.
Yeah.
And Ning. I prefer that.
Which one?
Ning. It's a new site. Yes, it's a new website, and it's quite good. Lots of photos, and I like it.
Great, so people can find you on those things as well.
Yeah.
Best of luck with the record. I like it very much.
And thank you.
Best of luck with the tour as well, Edwyn
Collins.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.